guy through the back just like he was a bait fish, a little white fish. Distance between him and I. I'm gonna pull him around over here. See if I can attract the attention of something big. Something just grabbed that ladyfish. Oh my god, it's big. Whatever it is. Oh boy. Oh, let's go chase him. That tells me I've got a shark on. Tells me I'm gonna see this thing and be like, uh-oh. Now what do I do? There he goes. Come on, I just want to get a glimpse of you. Oh, he just broke it. That is 80-pound fluorocarbon. Bit clean through. Dogfish bit through this piano wire. Don't you tell me my business again. Hoopa, rig up another one.
Marlin, Stingray, been through this piano wire. Don't you tell me my business again. You get back on the bridge.
That doesn't prove a damn thing. Gotcha.
Oh, look who's back. Man, I got that drag down tight. What is it? Make the drag too tight. Don't worry about him flipping me. I'll let him do whatever he's gonna do. This is the best sleigh ride I've ever been on, though, I'll tell you. right back home too. Nice, nice fish. For another run. Oh my God, you see that? This is not something I want next to the boat. Oh man. I just want to see you. That's all. He's close. He is close. This thing is so heavy. It's a nice shark. Yeah, that's a nice one. I'd say he's about a 6-footer. Holy shit, look at that. There's a freaking manatee behind me. Why are you under me, manatee? Look at that. What's up, buddy? Just enjoying the show. He's coming right for me again. That's pretty crazy. How crazy. That freaking manatee is right behind me. I'm not your mom, manatee. As if it weren't sick enough. That's pretty nuts. Wow, now there's jacks under me. Pretty crazy, huh? The manatee's just still following me around. That's interesting. I wonder if while I'm fighting this shark, I can get some underwater footage with the other camera. We'll see. Let's stow this a little bit better. Okay. There you go. There you go. How crazy is this? He's still there. Look at this guy. I'm going for a hell of a ride. Getting pulled around by this shark, and the manatee seems like he wants to see what's gonna happen. All right, let's get this guy next to the boat. When I hooked that really big snook, you guys taught me to let the drag do the work. Let the fish get tired. Don't horse him in, let him run when he wants to run. I'm using what you guys taught me right now by letting this fish run. I don't want to tighten that drag too much. I mean, I got heavy line on here, but still. Learn, Marty, learn. Let your tackle do the job. Quite frankly, I don't know what I'm going to do when this thing's next to the boat anyways. Yeah, he feels that extra pressure. There's the leader. There's the shark. That's a nice size shark. Not too bad. This guy's caught. That's all there is to it. There's the manatee, too. Manatee is like a hunting badger. He don't give a... Crazy thing, huh? A nice healthy shark. All right, I'm going to cinch it down a little bit. Oh, he doesn't like that. Oh, and he's off. Oh, man. That's what I get, I guess. Oh. You know, that was actually a pretty good lesson. If I should hook a tarpon, I will not tighten it down. I'll just let him get tired, however long it takes. I'll let the fish decide when the fight is over, instead of me deciding when the fight is over. I was kind of hoping to get some better underwater footage of that guy before I released him. Seems like the manatee's left too. He's like, all right, screw this. Newbie, you cinched down on the drag. You shouldn't have done that. I don't know. I pretty much knew what I was in for. You put a dead fish in the water around here, and you don't have to wait too long before a nice sized shark comes along and takes it. It was fun. Lesson learned.